Hey, welcome, welcome, welcome. Same strip, different cast. I'm DJ Prodigy that was waiting in the back room for about 5, 10, 15 minutes while seeing it and Movie Pop-Up have conversations without me.
But I mean, I don't know why you didn't include yourself.
I can't enter. The host can only put me in.
Well, how is it that I can enter and you can't?
It said waiting for host to put you in.
Oh no!
So honestly, I didn't know that. And I both said, "I don't know what Tony's doing. He's sitting right there. I don't know why."
Yeah, he's not clicking in.
I kept doing this in the corner.
Oh, you just said hi at all? Sorry.
And then I said something in group me like, "I'm here."
Oh, sorry.
That's cool. Man. I get it. I'm late all the time anyway.
It's okay.
Yeah, we know.
So today we're talking about scary movies and scary movie themes. Is it music?
Music. Yeah. Okay. So
music like.
Oh. Yeah.
What's his name?
That sounds like Jaws.
Jaws.
Yeah. Because I find it so amazing. See how this and what does it make you think of? The woman in water? Or her legs like this? Yeah, I think it's amazing like how you can hear a snippet of music and it can take you exactly to a scene in a movie and it just brings back, it's so nostalgic and brings back so many memories.
Or where you was when you first heard it.
Yeah, I think that's pretty cool. So I actually have a collection of songs. I think I went crazy. I got like 21. It's only 5 seconds each. It's only 5 seconds each. If y'all want to play along and see if you can not only try to guess the movie, maybe guess the composer, but where does the movie bring you back to? What scene do you think of as you hear the music?
Okay. All right, cool. I don't know about composer, but I can do...
Yeah, I probably would not get the composer either.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. All right.
You probably need James in here for that.
Oh, really?
I mean, I don't know. He might know the composer. I might know it because I might have it up on my
thing. You might, because some composers are pretty pretty popular. You know the name.
Well, I got my list of songs too, so I might have the composer.
Oh, nice. Okay. All right. Well, y'all ready to get started?
That's cool. Okay. I can talk about Comic-Con too later on.
Oh, yeah, that's gonna be really cool.
I'm so upset. Thank you for letting me know that it was this weekend and you was going. I truly appreciate it.
I kind of just found out. I'm sorry, best friend. Like, found out Thursday night, last minute, and didn't even know I was going. I was supposed to go to the football game, and somebody, a 10-year-old, said she'd rather not go to the football game that I already paid for.
Ooh. Oh, well, I'm sure you have fun. Yeah, I can't wait to hear about that.
Yeah, Janine went to the football game instead.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. All right, we're going to get... Okay. So, here we are with the...
I guess so. It's a Stephen King.
You said it's Stephen King?
Yeah.
Is that what you say, Prodigy?
No, because she was so quick. I was still listening.
Oh, no, because these are snippets.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
She said it's only 5 seconds.
Because I did like 21. I can't. I don't want to monopolize your time.
All right. I say it's Jason.
No.
Yeah, I think Jay Flicks would get this. That was Candyman.
Mm. Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. That was the first Candyman. And that composer is Philip Glass. So everything feels so lovely and romantic in Candyman. And those were actually like the credits coming on and going off was that song. All right. Moving on. Let's see. I knew Jay Flicks would get that.
That's Beetlejuice.
Damn. Yep. Yeah. You can't beat that one.
Right. I didn't hear it that well.
That's Halloween.
Yeah.
Did y'all know John Carpenter? Oh, you watch the movies that made us? You know that John Carpenter is also the composer for Halloween? Yeah.
I was shocked to hear that too.
And he did
that. For them to be so low budget and to be for it to be.
Then you do everything. And that's the same thing that happened with 2018. He composed that too.
What's up, Jay Flicks?
Yeah, I figured Jay Flex would know that. All right, so you got Halloween.
E.T.?
Yeah, that's a horror movie.
Not. Children of the Corn?
That's a very good guess.
Resident Evil?
You hear the children. That was...
Jeepers Creepers. No.
No. Caroline?
No.
Caroline?
No.
Poltergeist.
Oh, Poltergeist!
Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah, oh, okay. With the little girls and... Na, na, na.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Look into the light, Caroline! Oh!
Oh, I know this.
Oh, I know this one. It's okay. The one with, Jack Nicholson.
Oh.
The Shining.
Oh,
The Shining. Yeah.
Yep. Well, the Simpsons called it The Shining because they didn't want to get in trouble with copyright.
No copyright.
So, The Shining.
Okay, The Shining.
I got one. Right? I got one.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Oh, but DJ Pi just played this. Yeah. He just played that. Because it's so iconic. Now, this is hot. All right, y'all know what that is?
No.
Okay. No, that's The Omen.
I would never got that.
But it's not like how. Okay. But it's just a bad beat. These composers. I'm always
playing again. Resident Evil.
Okay.
Oh, I've heard this one. Is that Nightmare on Elm Street?
No.
But it'll give you nightmares. Oh, the other one. Sorry, that was Exorcist. Wait a second. Oh, shoot. I just went past a few. That was my bad. But that was the Exorcist. That's Baby Goat. That's Baby Goat. That's the Exorcist.
Okay.
So that's like the guy standing in front of the building with the shadow.
Right.
This one.
Oh, Busta Rhymes.
It's Busta Rhymes.
Is it though? Or is it Psycho? Yeah.
No, well, Busta Rhymes sampled it.
You did sample it. Here it is.
Come on. Yeah. Come on.
Okay. But yeah, that was Psycho.
It
sounds
like Juvenile.
It does?
Candyman. No, Master P. Ice Cream Man.
Is it a 1980s movie?
It is a 1980s movie.
I can tell by the sound.
Yeah. Well, actually, so that was a 1988 movie, and this is the 2019 movie.
Of the same movie?
Same name.
I don't know this one.
Is it Pet Cemetery?
It's Child's Play. But that was a good guess.
Oh, you know what? That's one of my songs.
And the thing is, it's like the whole thing, it sounds kind of childish. So those were those two.
I've seen I Spit on Your Grave. That is a crazy movie.
That I have not seen.
How have I seen it? You haven't.
Right. How is is movie papa watching this stuff?
I know it seems a little gory for me.
No, things that you know we do when you're with you know whatever.
Oh, okay, never mind. Moving on.
Okay,
that's why I told Janine no, call Teresa.
Yeah, it is Jay Flex. It,
yes, that is it. Mm-hmm. Good.
It sounds like down in a sewer.
Mm-hmm.
I know this too.
You do? Okay.
It's a Stephen King movie.
Yeah, I knew Jay Flix would get all these. Nah. Y'all don't know this.
I've heard it before, but I can't. I can't.
This is actually.
Can you play it again?
Yeah. Let me. Okay. One moment. Let me see. I think this is it. Okay.
I know it. I should know it.
Y'all want to know?
Yeah.
So my children's. It's a children's story. It's Peter and the Wolf.
Oh, see, I've heard
that was a scary movie.
Well, it was scary. It's like a scary fable. There's no dialogue. It's just the music, and the music acts out each character. So the duck is like rah, rah, rah. The wolf who like eats the duck.
Yeah, I remember the beginning part
as a kid. Yeah, so that's Peter and the Wolf.
Yeah.
Oh, good one. Us. This is us.
Yeah, it's us. Yeah, you can't beat this song. So what do y'all saw us in the theater?
I saw us. Janine, for some reason, has not seen it. She don't. I don't know why.
I saw us this. No. Which one is us?
Us is actually on the screen with the two. That's us.
So what, in 2019, I went on a bus trip to eat crabs and go to the casino. Mm-hmm. And on the way back, they played us on the bus.
Oh, okay.
And, you know, I was sitting, it was like the two seats, and I was sitting there watching it through the little separation of the seats. But I kind of watched it like this the whole time.
I think I saw that the movie theater in the same situation that Stephanie was talking about earlier.
Oh, no. I know I saw it in the theater, but I know when the music came on, myself and my nieces, we were dancing because I was like, this is jamming. What are all the rabbits at the wall? That was cool. Okay, we'll move to the next one. I know it's not really music. I mean, this could be a tough one.
I can't hear it.
Oh.
Yeah. What was that? I heard it, but I don't
know. It might be really faint. The thing is that's the very beginning of Scream. It's just missing the phone ringing from it.
Really? Play it? Mm-hmm. Well, okay. Mm-hmm.
I'll go back. It's like, it's not long. It's like seconds. This. Okay. Okay. Yeah, it's really not long.
The Scorpion King. This giving me like Egyptian, the mummy vibe, like in the desert and
the mummy.
I mean, it sounded like it was almost Aladdin, to be honest with you. I really thought it was Aladdin when it first came.
I heard that it's actually from a TV show about a serial killer.
Oh no, Sherlock Holmes.
Serial Dexter.
Walking Dead.
Yeah.
Woo! Yeah.
I got two. I'm on the roll. I'm the winner. X-Files.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So y'all know
y'all
stuff.
TV stuff.
No, this one might be tough.
I don't have a clue.
Did y'all see Devil?
No.
I did see Devil. Devil's the one in the elevator, right?
Yes. Like one by one, you don't know what's going on. Yeah, that was that one. That was Devil. So that's like the opening scene where everything is flipped over. Yeah. Okay. And so
I went to the movies to see that.
Okay. And so movie pop up. You said 13 Ghosts. What is that one of your movies?
Was
it 13 Ghosts? Did you mention Child's 13
Play Ghosts? That you played it earlier?
Oh,
you
saw okay.
That, yeah. Yeah, okay. Child's Play was one of mine.
Okay, I gotcha. Okay.
I only got two. I don't have as many as you do. I'm sorry.
I only got two too.
Oh, Stranger Things.
You knew it immediately. Okay.
Sheesh. I have that as a ring. Well, when I used to have an Android, that was my ringtone.
I like that.
Oh, he didn't let that play. Like I could rock out for that.
I can too.
Beetlejuice.
Don't. Oh, for real? Y'all don't know what that is? Seriously? That's Saw.
Oh. I'm not a big fan of Saw, so.
Oh, but that's such a nice song. You can really rock out to it. Right. Oh, that was you? Okay.
Only got a couple more. You played it? I'm sorry.
And then TJ Prodigy, you can go. Or Movie Pop Up, y'all can go. I'm almost done.
I was getting mine in queue.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Play that again?
No, it wasn't me. I was getting mine in queue. I'm sorry. I didn't realize you can hear it. That was my fault.
Okay. Mine isn't playing. I think that's... Is that it? Oh, shoot. That might have been it. Because I think Saw was it. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much. Yay. Yeah, I did well.
So I got two. Definitely got two.
Okay.
Jay Flix got four. Good job. Jay Flix,
yeah,
the winner.
Yeah. Yeah, because he knew Saw. I was just like, y'all don't know. Mm-hmm. Jing, jing, jing. Flap, flap, flap. Okay.
I mean, you dancing to it. I was more probably running from it when the song.
No, but you got the crescendo. I love the composer.
I prefer to run from Saw than dance.
No, it's good. Nah. These composers, they're awesome.
So I don't necessarily have a song, but I thought something. It's a minute. I think it's under 2 minutes long, and I want. Okay.
Okay.
So this is Iman Shumpert. Tiana Taylor's husband, whatever his Shumpert. Name is. Whatever.
Iman Shumpert.
Yeah, Iman Shumpert. On Dancing with the Stars. He's on Dancing with the Stars. Okay. So okay. This is his thing.
Iman Shumpert.
Temple.
Okay.
With his partner Daniela, it's Iman Shumpert.
No. They doing Us? They are doing Us. Cool. Creep on in. Nice. Yes, girlfriend, I love that. That's lit.
And she probably did most of the choreography too.
Yeah, she's the dancer.
Yeah. Whoa. I'm giving them 10.
This is not a bad song to dance to, but you just got
to
tick to the beat.
Oh my God. That is crucial.
Jay Flick said he's cheating.
That is so much trust. Look at their faces, though. That's awesome.
The judges
if you
might
like
not never
that
seen
Dancing with the Stars video. Do not forget to subscribe.
The judges might not never seen it before.
I would give them straight 10s.
So they did. They got a perfect score of 40.
Yeah.
They got
that's a lot of trust because he was flipping and flapping her.
I wonder if the judges knew what they was watching, though.
Oh,
besides,
God.
As far as the actual theme part of it.
I know.
I'm pretty sure they knew it was Us. Us. I mean, that was a big, significant movie when it came out.
Yeah.
With all the publicity that it got from it and everything. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. That ending was kind of scary. It was. Yeah. Just stand there looking at him.
Yeah, I was like, don't drop her. All right. But Tiana Taylor, because that's his lady, right?
Right.
Yep,
yeah. So she probably helped them too.
Oh yeah, probably. They probably dance at home all the time. They probably got poles and stuff at the house. So yeah. they always practicing.
I guess they always doing stuff.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But that was cool. That was good.
But that was kind of it for me. I had that in Child's Play, but he mm-hmm. played Child's Play, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, all right, sorry. Let me see what I got.
Mm-hmm.
See if y'all can guess these.
Oh, she got pole. Okay. That sounds like Holly Brown. That's Holly Brown?
What's the name of it, though?
Holly Brown's Halloween Christmas.
No.
Oh, you talking about Blow Branford Blow? Like who really did it?
No, though. No. What's the name of the TV special?
Oh, Halloween Christmas.
It's not Halloween Christmas.
Halloween.
Halloween
Brown's Halloween special.
The Great Pumpkin.
Oh gosh, it's the Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown. All right.
Y'all supposed to know that.
OJ Flicks, I actually have continued to watch I Know What You Did Last Summer. I thought it was a bunch of teenage angst. But now I'm like on episode 5. It's an okay whodunit.
So that's the main reason why I haven't watched it yet, because I thought it was going to be a whole bunch of teenagers.
Yeah.
I wasn't impressed about it either. Janine was, yeah. She's a little interested in it.
I'm interested in it now, but it took 5 episodes to get to this point because the first one is just teenage, blah, blah. So once you get past that, it's like, okay, who done it? It is now a whodunit, so now I want to know.
How many episodes is it?
I think it's like 4 or 5, and they only release them every Friday because I would damn sure go to episode 10 right now and just find out who's doing all this. That is where I am. But it's a week to week, so I can't even skip to the end. So, all
right.
But it's okay. I'm intrigued now. I'm into it now.
Let me know if it's too loud.
What is this? Movie
out of E.T. I think it's E.T.
It sounds like something about outer space.
Oh, the Encounters?
It sounds like something from outer space, though.
You're close to the outer space. You won.
You said Close Encounters of the Third Kind. I don't know what else it would be.
You warm with the outer space.
You say it's not E.T.?
No, you're warm with the outer space.
Oh, with the outer space? It's not aliens. It doesn't sound like aliens, though.
That's not Goonies.
You say what? What'd you say?
Is it Mac and Me?
Nope. Seen it. Say it got close to it. What'd you say, Susanna?
I don't even know what I said.
Aliens.
It is aliens?
Alien, the first one.
Wow. I said it can't be aliens.
So wait a minute, tell me, is it alien or aliens?
The first one, alien.
Alien. Oh.
I wouldn't. It doesn't seem. It doesn't seem necessary. Oh, that's Twilight Zone. I want. Oh, that's the
Adam's Family.
That's Psycho. Because that's the night.
Shower scene.
That's the night. Oh, that's Beetlejuice. Oh, that's Tales from the Crypt.
Jeez.
Johnny Elfman. My voice is here. Oh, that's 18.
I'm so traumatized. It was a nice song though.
Yeah.
They ruined that song with that killer monster.
Hey,
I gotta get more. See my shirt.
Yay, Squiggles. Well, I'm a whoreholic. E.T. is not a horror movie.
It is a horror movie, James.
E.T. is a horror movie because
bubbling, so is that like a blob? Is something really bubbling? That's not like a blob movie. Is that a TV show?
Is it Frankenstein?
It's a movie.
It's a movie?
The Nightmare on Elm Street.
Is it The Fly?
The Nightmare on Elm Street.
Nightmare on Elm Street.
Okay. Maybe that was Freddy's blood boiling or his skin popping. I don't know.
I don't have that much more. I gotta get some more. Most of the stuff I got.
Was that
most
true?
Stuff I got is Halloween songs.
It's implied.
Stranger.
Yeah, it's taking too long for that movie to come out. I mean, that TV show to come back.
I know, but they're gonna be in college when they come back. I put a spell on you.
Well, I saw the thing coming out of the sky. It had one long horn, one big eye. Like a Mr. Shaking in the city.
Teresa, know it.
Is this a 1-5 purple people eat?
Yeah, purple people eat.
I have never heard of that.
This is old school, like 50s.
Because you know what? We... The color purple. No, we used to sing this in class. Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Okay. She got it. You seen that movie before, Steph?
What?
The Rocky Horror Picture Show?
Yeah.
Oh! Little Shop of Horrors?
Yeah, my bad. Little Shop of Horrors, yeah.
Okay.
Right. I've seen what.
Hello, I'd like to see Dr. Slumber, please.
Do you have an appointment, sir?
No, I don't, but tell the doctor it's urgent that I see her.
Well, just one moment. Dr. Slumber, there's a young man out here named... Excuse me, what is your name?
Is that Dr. Dre?
Tell us, Dana Dane.
Dana Dane Nightmares.
Oh, you can do it right now.
Thank you.
Well, I walked into the office, what did I see? A well-shaped body with the back to me, sitting in a chair with...
Oh, Nightmare on My Street. That's DJ Jazzy Jeff from Fresh Prince.
Yeah.
It was a nightmare in on my street.
That's pretty much it. She played most of the stuff that I ever got, too.
Oh, you did?
I do have one more song.
Okay. This sounds like Monster Mash. It is? But them bubbles sound like a
thriller.
I was working in the lab late one night when my eyes beheld.
Come on, movie pop ups.
My monster from his slab.
Come on, movie pop up. This is what our ancestors used to do in the 40s.
He did the monster mash. The monster mash. It was a graveyard.
Yeah.
That's what they used to do before they ran from the cops. Sorry.
I hate you.
Sorry. I mean, it's true.
Bring us back up.
Well, I got one for you. I don't know. Let me see if I could play it. Let me know if you guys can hear this, okay?
Okay.
Can you hear it?
Yes.
I love this movie.
It's a horror movie.
It's Harry Potter. It sounds very whimsical. Is this Hocus Pocus? It's not Hocus Pocus. It sounds
Hocus Pocus.
Very whimsical.
Very. It's Hocus Pocus.
Okay.
It was Hocus Pocus.
Is that considered scary?
No, but it's a Halloween.
It's a fun Halloween movie.
It's Halloween. They have witches. It's Halloween and witches.
Introduction. Mm-hmm. You remember this?
I put a spell on. And now you're mine.
Really? You don't know this, Teresa?
From the, at the TV station?
I am live.
You still know it, remember it though, right? That's when they went to the Halloween party with the parents, and she was put a spell on them, and she had them, the parents, there at the party all night long singing.
Now
No, I have to watch it again. It's been, I have not watched it in years.
I watch Hocus Pocus every Halloween.
I'm going to watch it. I'm going to watch it. I'm going to watch it.
Yeah.
I just found a Halloween,
a long time.
Halloween theme. I guess I did have it.
Oh, meow, 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 meow. John Carpenter.
Can you play it? Let me hear it. Was it? She said BMB. I can't identify.
No, because you did. You identified it when I played it.
Oh, that. Okay. Yeah, yeah. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry.
You heard this?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that might be it.
I'll turn it on IMB. All right. So, Cena, you also challenged us to figure out our favorite actors and what movies, what horror movies have they been in.
Right.
So I have, I guess, a male and a female.
Okay.
My female favorite actress, she has not been, if she has, I don't know what it was and I didn't see it. But okay. I haven't seen her in a horror movie.
Really?
Julia Roberts.
Mm-hmm.
And I even Googled it.
You might be right. I can't think of her. She's been in suspenseful movies.
Right. Exactly. Exactly. So.
Yeah. Like Sleeping with the Enemy, stuff like that. You're right.
Yeah.
I don't recall her being in a horror movie.
I don't recall her being in a horror movie, too. Okay. But my favorite, to this day, he's still my favorite actor.
Mm-hmm.
I remember him growing up. And watching his movies, it was like, I don't know, it made me so, I don't know. But my favorite actor is Bruce Willis.
Mm-hmm.
And the horror movie that he's been in that I guess technically is not necessarily a horror movie, but it is because it did scare the crap out of me watching it.
Mm-hmm.
The Sixth Sense.
Yeah. I think that Sixth Sense is still considered a horror movie. It had a lot of elements that scared you.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the little boy is seeing dead people, seeing ghosts and apparitions. So I still think that's considered, that would be more like a paranormal type of a, you say it's not a horror movie? Then what's considered a horror movie? It should be anything that scares you. It shouldn't just like only be blood or something like that. I don't think that's fair because not all movies have that type of, scared for people.
Technically, it's not considered as one. It's considered a drama, mystery, and a thriller.
I can see thriller. Okay.
So yeah, maybe... I see thriller as well, too.
Okay.
E.T. is not a scary movie.
It's not.
E.T. is just a spoiled little child that just couldn't get his way and decided to act out.
Gosh, I didn't know it was that bad. I don't know if I would do that. Okay. All right, so Prodigy, do you have your
pick? Yeah, Kristen Stewart is my favorite, and she was in Twilight.
Not exactly a horror movie. She was also
she was in Underworld though. Underwater.
Yeah, Underwater. I would definitely say that. Yeah, or the Messenger.
Movie Papa. What? I don't understand why you and Janine always look at me crazy. Kristen Stewart is a dope actress. You guys always.
I thought you were talking about that. You try to classify Twilight as a horror movie?
No. Oh gosh. It is a movie about vampires. Could that be considered horror?
No.
B-rated horror.
Story. It's a drama.
And then Denzel Washington, and he was in Fallen.
Yeah, Fallen is good though.
Fallen was what's that?
Fallen was just like time is on your side. It's a lot of killing, and it's a lot of spirits being gone from one person to the next. Well, I'm just out here to play with you today.
That's the only really scary movie I remember him being in.
Okay, so it says it's an action, crime, drama, fantasy, mystery, and thriller.
What is that's Fallen? All those things.
Mm-hmm. Wow. So let me go back to the Sixth Sense, maybe. Yeah.
Mm-mm. I guess would the little things be scary, or is that more like a detective?
What would be scary?
That just came out last year.
What?
The Little Things. Remember, he was in the movie called The Little Things.
I didn't see Little Things.
It actually came out this year, January 2021.
Okay. The Little Things.
Yeah, him and Jared Leto was in it. Jared Leto was a serial killer.
Oh, so that would be a thriller. It's a mystery and a thriller.
Okay, I can see that with the thriller. Yeah. Could you say what's the different definition of horror? Horror is something I feel like that scares people.
like what I would consider horror might not be for others. I'll holler at y'all with the definition, because I don't think it should just
an be intense feeling of fear, shock, or disgust.
Yeah.
That's yeah. it.
Because I can tell you, I had anxiety during Sixth Sense. I can say that.
I had anxiety too.
I had anxiety during Sixth Sense, so I was watching that just like, what's going on? Same thing, not E.T. I didn't have any anxiety during
Excuse Twilight. Excuse me?
I didn't have any anxiety.
E.T. gave me anxiety.
Then it's a horror to you. I get it. But like stuff that's just like, what is going on?
So I Google horror movie definition. Yeah. A horror film is one that seeks to elicit fear or disgust in its audience for entertainment purposes. Yeah. Horror films additionally aim to invoke viewers' nightmares, revulsions, or terror of the unknown.
Okay.
Horror may also overlap with the fantasy, supernatural, fiction, and theater genres.
And it can overlap, yeah. So would you consider Seven a horror film? I would consider that, because you have a serial killer who's leaving these bodies all disfigured. Did y'all not have any type of anxiety when the policeman went into that one room with all of the different trees hanging down? And then that that junkie, I don't know the correct term for junkie, but the junkie started coughing. It was like this. It was like this. And it was so skinny that even if you shined a light in the junkie, I mean, it was scary because the guy was all up in his face and then he jumped up.
But you know, if that's the case, and we can consider a lot of movies to be scary. And then because of this definition, I mean, we can give Prodigy we can agree with Prodigy that E.T. is scary because it invoked fear in him.
Right. Yeah.
I don't think I would consider Seven a horror movie.
Experience as a 4-year-old.
It definitely was a thriller, a horror thriller. Okay. Yeah.
Because, like, even as a kid growing up, I could tell you what scared me. Beetlejuice, Little Shop of Horrors, those scared me as a kid.
Well, Terminator was, I didn't like, Terminator 2 was scary to me.
Really?
When I was younger.
And that would be like a thriller or something.
It was violent as heck to me. As I guess a 10-year-old, 9-year-old, there was a lot going on. They were showing stuff.
You know what? I agree with you on that, because Predator.
When he took
off his mask and I saw his face, I had nightmares. Not just that,
people's arms getting shot off, people's heads getting shot off. That stuff was
taking out entire spines.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
That stuff to me was scary to me watching it.
Yeah, because the thing is, it's like, I think it's horror, and then you have the different, you have thriller, you have psychological, you have ghosts, you have paranormal, you have very different genres and stuff, but different things scare different people. I think it really depends on the person, instead of just like the slash them ups.
Predator petrified me. I was terrified.
Ooh, I would consider Predator a horror movie.
I get why people would think look at it as an action thriller, but I also can see it being a horror too.
But Alien, isn't Alien Alien?
Alien's a sci-fi. Sci-fi movie, horror, but it's a horror to me. It's a horror.
But it's like sci-fi horror,
right?
Yeah, so, but I agree with that.
Scary. I feel like it's still scary. It's just scary in space,
right?
Still scary. Yeah.
The whole point was to scare you,
and you were the chest bursting out scene,
right?
Just like various scenes. Every scene of them going into a close contained area.
Which movie? You talking about Aliens?
I'm still on Aliens. Anytime it's there,
sci-fi.
Yeah, if they're still going into like different parts and tunnels and stuff like that, you have anxiety like, is the alien going to get them now, sort of a thing. So I feel like that's still horror.
Alien is horror sci-fi.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
So Aliens?
It's in space.
Aliens is an action-adventure sci-fi thriller.
Beetlejuice wasn't scary to me.
Growing up, to me, it was. Like all of the different... ghosts,
right? I guess Beetlejuice was fine. I was actually fine watching that, but then
Beetlejuice,
I would watch
comedy and fantasy. The only scary thing to me in Beetlejuice was the part when the banister, the rail, turned into a snake.
Yeah,
that was it.
Come for your daughter, Chuck. Yeah, that
that whole thing. Yep.
Yeah. But yeah, I wasn't watching no Chucky or Nightmare on Elm Street. I wasn't watching none of that stuff.
Oh my God. I still remember Chucky climbing up them stairs.
You talking about the little man. The little man dressed as Chucky climbing up them stairs.
I look, you want to know what when we saw that part of what we felt? Yes. That scared the crap out of me.
Hold up. Let me go get him real quick. He's right here. Hold up. He got something to say.
You didn't have to do that.
Shit he got to say.
You didn't have to do that.
He's right here though. That's why. He's like, he knew what was going on.
So the thing of it is,
yes, Jay Flix.
No, but see, that's the thing. Once you read the definition of it, that's basically what the definition is: something that's inflict fear in a person for the sake of entertainment. So,
I would say the first Jurassic Park.
That wasn't scary to me.
Oh, that was scary as hell.
I loved that. I was so excited.
I can definitely tell you, my heart was pumping that entire movie.
That wasn't scary at all.
That's an intense movie. I mean, you have the T-Rex in the car. You have
two kids,
and then they trying to. That's
your
E.T. movie. Then,
because that should have been scary.
I guess to Jay Flick's point, I mean, I feel like we're derailing of what a horror really is based off this definition. Mm-hmm. I feel like once we stick to, if we stay in the parameters,
Star Wars could be scary. Not to me. But I can see somebody scared of Darth Vader as a kid.
Okay.
I can see a kid being scared of Darth Vader. You can't see a kid being scared of Darth Vader, Stephanie, really?
Because I saw Star Wars as a kid and I was not afraid.
I'm just saying.
I was afraid of things though.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I mean, he didn't scare me, but I guess.
I mean, I get your point. I get the point. I get mm-hmm.
Maybe if they didn't see the movie, if Darth Vader walked on to some 4-year-olds that never knew who he was at nighttime, he probably would freak the heck out of
them. He probably freak him out. He would. I think he would, because you have that deep voice.
Right.
It's going to take me so long to get props together. Sorry.
Yeah, but that's.
Children might be afraid of that. They might be. I don't think it might be a horror to that person, but I don't think it would fall on the genre of it, because I feel like you would need a majority of people to agree with that type of a definition.
Right.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I agree.
So because a majority, you know, that could just be a personal thing. It's just like E.T. is personal. Jurassic Park for me is personal. So.
Monster Inc. This was not scary.
I like that. That was so upbeat.
Yeah, well, I don't have no other hot. No, I gotta get some more stuff, but I don't have nothing.
Yeah, I mean,
on,
that's
I am
all
on the Halloween too. Halloween raid train on Sunday at 4.
What's the poll? What is a horror movie? Or what's your poll, Jay Flix? Your suggestion.
He said you should make a poll. Terrified Jamie as a kid. What terrified Jamie? Because see, Savannah can watch Stranger Things, have no issue watching it, and been watching it for like 5 years now since, and mm-hmm. none of that stuff scares her. She watches it like it's nothing. Mm-hmm. But her mother will put on something crazy like Nightmare on Elm Street or Chucky in the middle at night, watching it while she's mm-hmm. trying to sleep, and that mm-hmm. stuff sticks in her head.
Yeah,
I think it's the difference from, because it's more the death coming from those type of movies is more graphic than Stranger Things, I'm guessing.
Well, second season was a little graphic when our friend from the Goonies, or Hobo Baggins, when he died, that was graphic.
Yeah. But that wasn't. But that happened later on.
When they showed the monster was a little scary.
That happened later on too. I mean, Chucky's killing people like every 5 minutes almost.
Yeah. By the way, can I bring this up real quick? Have y'all seen Chucky series on Sci-Fi Network?
No,
It's teenage.
Netflix, angst. We should. We'll do that. We can. Post no. That
I ain't watching it.
It's a little bit of teenage angst, but I see where they're going with it, and I'm like, cool. It has Charles Mancini, who was the creator of Chucky, and the Stephen Dorff, the guy who's always done the voice. He's doing the voice of Chucky in this. And I have to say, oh, Chucky is ignorant and hilarious. He is an asshole. I watch it for that. It's USA and Sci-Fi. Actually, I think they're like one network now. You can watch. You don't even have to have the cable channels. They broadcast them on YouTube. So you can watch the first two episodes through YouTube if you want to. But I like that Chucky is such an asshole and says what he thinks. So watch it for him, because he... I like his words, and he cusses and everything. Little Boy's okay. I like that they, Charles Mancini, the creator of the show, is gay. And so he kind of weaves in his story of growing up like that. And so the main character that owns the Chucky doll, this kid, he's probably like 13 or 14 or something, and he's gay. And it shows him going through everything, being a gay teenager. He has his doll. He makes sculptures. He's being picked on. Chucky is telling him maybe he should... correct these people who are picking on him, sort of thing. But it's so funny because, like, man, I would never do anything like that to you. I like it for the doll, for Chucky and his sayings. So,
okay.
Check it out. Since we're speaking of Chucky, your friend to the end. Check out the show. He's your friend.
Definitely my friend. I believe the lady, let me see what her name is. The Bride of Chucky. I believe she's in it as well, too. Because I seen her on something.
You didn't know how old his dad was. Yeah.
I seen her on something kind of promoting it.
Promoting Chucky or, I'm sorry.
Yeah, Jennifer Tilly. I seen her.
Oh, yeah, she's in it.
Yeah.
Yep.
Uh-huh. Now, I did go to the movie to see The Bride of Chucky.
Cool. Is that the one that had Redman?
Listen, I don't remember.
I don't know. But I'll tell you. Another reason to probably watch this show, the little boy who played Andy in original Chucky's in this.
Oh, I think I did hear that as well, too.
Yeah, so I think that's pretty neat. All right, so I'll put that.
I got you, stuff
out there.
Yeah, so for me, I'm good.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Understood.
So I wonder what Andy looks like now. Let me go and see.
He looks like a 40-year-old man.
Well, I don't if anything else you have, Teresa, because I'll talk about Comic-Con for a hot minute before we get
out. Talk about Comic-Con. Yep, that's all that go I have for our
score. Thank you for letting me know all about it.
No shade again.
I got my shade on. No, because I had RJ here. His best friend was here Saturday, and we literally did nothing.
Are they vaccinated?
RJ is. I don't know about his best.
Because they made Savannah. They made anybody not vaccinated take a COVID test before you got in there. It was $30 on top of the $30 to pay to get in. So I had to pay $60 for us two, and then another $30 for her to get a COVID test. And so if I didn't go
down, COVID test, like they gave you the results.
Yeah, they swabbed both her nostrils, and it was a rapid test. You wait 15 minutes, and we got there. They opened at 10. We got down there at 9:30, so we can wait in line to take the test.
Mm-hmm.
But I went down there Saturday to buy the tickets at the convention center, because again, I found out Thursday night they had online tickets, so you had to actually go to the convention center to get it. I went down there Saturday, waited in the long line Saturday, thinking I can just walk in. But by the time I got in, they was like, you can't come in without a vaccine card or COVID. I don't keep my vaccine card with me.
I keep mine with me.
So I was like, she was like, I said, I'm just trying to buy tickets. I'm not trying to actually go in. So finally someone let me buy tickets, but they were like, well, your daughter is not vaccinated, so she has to take the test. So I'm glad I found that out Saturday, because we would have been pissed if I would have came in on Sunday without my card and still had to get her vaccinated after paying for parking and all that type of stuff.
Yeah, so, that's good to know. Tested too.
This vaccination is real. Always keep your card on you. That's what I've learned so far.
Now, you're right, Teresa. And now I do.
Had to use my card once. That's when I went to New York to the Wine and Food Festival.
Okay.
First time anybody had asked me to see my car.
Jay Felix he would have waited in the car.
Daddy gonna tell you everything that happened. Girl's gonna be like, you would have had a whole
right.
I face. Now
she was a trooper. She did it. She was a trooper. They stuck. They put it in both her nostrils. They didn't go way back. They don't have to go all the way back no more. So they just did the like halfway in your nose. They don't go all the way back. Mm-hmm. So it wasn't as bad as she thought it was gonna be. Like she hurt. So and then it took 15 minutes. We got the test anyway. We went inside. It was pretty dope. They had definitely a whole bunch of comic stands with a whole bunch of different people. Mm-hmm. That was either autographing comics, where I have no clue who these people were, people waiting in line for, and but it was so much like toys and like custom made like shirts and paintings and stuff. All that stuff was cool. I got this from.
Is that Spider-Man?
Yeah, I got the guy was drawing a whole bunch of these, and he autographed mine. I gotta get a frame for it. But it's the black Spider-Man sitting on top of
I'm trying to get it close. Roof.
Yeah. And I don't know if he's a big artist or not. He had a big booth, but he signed it. So I'm gonna get it framed because you never know. I don't know who these people are. But there was a lot of stuff there. It was cool. Savannah had a dope time, but after 3 hours, she was done. Yeah. So it's a lot of walking. And then spending money, of course, because every time they had like these custom Legos. You can get Marvel, Stranger Things, Star Wars, and your little Lego figurines that these people were making. So they were taking plain Legos and making a whole bunch of, she got a Falcon Winter Soldier, like the Captain America Falcon.
Yeah.
That's not even, you can't even buy that. They custom made it.
And that is so cool. So
she wanted that, and she got a Stranger Things one and some other stuff. But it was a good memory for her, but Stephanie, I got you next year because I want to go every year now.
I want to go next year, please.
I am a little familiar with it, and it's totally my fault. Once I saw your pictures, because I know it's around October when it comes.
I had no clue. We went to the comic book store that's right around the corner from here on Thursday night, and they were packing up to go to Comic-Con for Friday. And we were like, Comic-Con? And that's the guy. And when we went down, one of the guys that runs it was working Comic-Con. Like, he's working the convention center. And
wow,
he was like,
okay.
So it was cool to know him because he was somebody that could direct us around a little bit. But I had no clue either, Stephanie. So now I know to look out for it. And we can buy tickets in advance. And you know, so it was cool.
I know a couple of years ago, RJ and I was in New York, and it just so happened it was Comic-Con that weekend that we was there, and we was walking the streets and everybody was in their cosplay, and I was like, what is going on? Kind of find out it was the New York Comic-Con.
Right.
We did go to that, but it was so packed we couldn't get in.
What?
It was so much. It was so busy.
You gotta prepare. Yeah. I talked to Diva.
I was not prepared for it.
I talked to Diva before I went to this one. Because she, you know, she's in California, so she's been to the one out there.
Well, San Francisco or San Diego?
She's in L.A.
The
big boy's in L.A.
Okay. I
thought women in Vegas had one.
Yeah, they go around the country. They go around the whole country.
I always heard of it in Vegas.
But I think the L.A. was one of the first ones, so it's one of the biggest ones. But I just wanted to know what they expect, so she gave me some input in a little bit, but she wasn't sure how big this one would be compared to hers. And I don't think it was as big, but it was big enough for me. But it wasn't a lot of cosplay. It was a lot of people dressed up.
San Diego. Okay.
But it wasn't a lot of people dressed to the T. It was a couple people like that. Like this one guy had Savannah took a picture with him. What's the Baby Yoda's? Not Baby Yoda, but the other guy with Baby Yoda.
The Mandalorian.
He had the Mandalorian outfit on. Had the sound through the helmet and everything. It was dope. He had to wait for a COVID test. That's something where I know, because he was standing in front of me with his mask off for 15 minutes waiting.
I wonder if this girl, this lady that I follow on IG, TikTok. I don't know her name.
You could have went down there as whatever, Teresa. Okay. You could have been Michael Myers if you wanted to.
No, I don't think that's a horror convention, which I am all for.
Yeah, but it's still, what are they going to tell you? No, you can't come in here?
I can't think of this.
They're going to look at me like a peasant. You don't belong here.
Why would they look at you like that?
I'm about to say, why would they? I'm sure there's horror comic books there, though. I'm sure somebody there is selling horror comic books.
That's a very good point. Because it was a lot Walking Dead was a comic, so yeah.
It was a lot of new people down there breaking, I guess, trying to break their first comic book. And you know, they were not annoying, but you would walk past them, come here, guy, here, check this out, read this. Let me tell you the whole story of my book. And I'm just
listen to my demo.
Like they would stand there and try to tell me and Savannah the whole plot of the comic. And you know, she don't care because it's not Marvel, she's just into Marvel or DC. And we did buy one comic for one black new artist.
Okay.
And he was pretty dope. He didn't rush us or nothing. Okay. And his comic looked cool. And Savannah actually saw that it looks cool. And signed her initial book, his first one. So okay. You never know what could happen. He could.
And that's a very good point, because even like 30 Days of Night, like a lot of things, I mentioned Walking Dead, The Boys. Weren't right. all these comics
right.
beforehand? Even the one where the son gets beat up all the time.
Yeah, yeah, that one, right.
That one too. Like all Invincible. Of these comics. So that's a good right. point. Okay,
and that's what I was telling Savannah. I said, this guy might not stay with this comic. He could move on to Marvel and grow from them. You never know. But now you have a.
You got to start from somewhere.
Yeah, you have
always. From him. Yeah.
I was like, so don't mess it up. I said, you should keep it. You know, let's keep this comic. And you know, you can read it, but let's put it back in its case.
Always evolve. Yep. Mm-hmm.
That's but it was a lot. It was a lot like that. And then of course the big boys were down there too. But it was cool. I'll definitely will go back.
Okay.
So maybe it was something we can all do as a group that everybody can go. J Flix, all of us next year.
Well, I really want to go to the one in San Diego, and I think I might do that for RJ for his birthday. He turned 16.
Oh, that'd be dope.
Yeah, that would. So I'd be interested in doing that. I definitely want to do the San Diego one.
So that's the San Diego is the big one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because I knew New York, started. I'm sure,
and you said New York was big too?
Well, yeah, New York was big. It was bigger than I was like, oh my gosh. Like, wow.
It was original though. That's what J Flix was saying. So no, and I San think Diego, that it did start over there. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But I mean, New York is just as big. It's bigger than Baltimore.
I'm sure because it's New York. I'm sure. They have to come with the, yeah. I get that.
So KC, I was just curious, this girl that I follow. Hey, KC's one of my homegirls.
Hey, KC.
But yeah, it's a girl that I follow on TikTok. She makes all her costumes herself.
Okay.
And she also sometimes she do like little videos on how like what she's putting together. Some things she actually really, really buy. But she's, I was wondering, oh, she did. She did. She went to New York Comic Con. Damn.
Okay.
I definitely wouldn't want to meet her. I was in New York that weekend, too.
Okay. AJ Flix. Okay, cool. So San Diego.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind going back, checking that one out, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so San Diego, I mean, well, RJ, he turned 16 in 2 years. So, I mean, of course, it won't be Ryan's birthday, but that'll be early.
Yeah, but that'll be
in the summertime. Yeah. I think that'll be a good time to be over COVID.
And they had different prices for different days. Saturday was the most expensive, which was probably the
busiest. Nope, I was going on a Thursday. Did they have
Had Friday, Saturday, Sunday here. Here. I'm not sure about the other ones, but here.
I was going on Wednesday afternoon.
So the cheapest
ticket, the cheapest tickets was Friday.
Friday it
is. And then Sunday and then Saturday. Saturday was the most expensive tickets.
Nah, I wouldn't go Saturday.
So did they have panelists, like discussions and things like that?
Yeah, they had, that's what I'm saying. It was people down there. I just had no clue who these people were. But it was no big name like movie stars down there. It was like artists or like comic book artists and stuff.
So it was on a smaller scale.
Right. Now they did have the shield, which they claim from Captain America's Endgame shield was down there, and it was autographed. Mm-hmm. It was from the actual shield. So Savannah took a picture next to that. Okay. It was in a case. They was doing a raffle for it. You to get it. You had to, of course, it probably went for a lot of money. If it was the authentic one, I mean, I don't know how you can tell. I mean
it's just Christopher. It's just Christopher Shield.
It's Chris Evans Shield.
It's Christopher, right. It's just Chris.
Yeah, but it's an Endgame. It's the actual shield that he was on your left.
I could have swore you said Captain
Marvel. If I said Captain Marvel, I meant Captain America.
Oh, okay.
No. I'm just like, it's just, he didn't really help in game.
What do you mean he didn't help?
It's all fictitious. It's a fiction.
Who
What are we paying for?
All right, it's time to raid out.
Okay.
Don't be talking about my boyfriend.
No, he's awesome. He wears really nice cable sweaters. I saw him in Knives Out, but I'm just saying. No. But go ahead, raid out.
All
right. I'm so confused right now.
No, he wears really good cable sweaters.
We're gonna go over this.
So women,
he was a man in Endgame.
I need to process this.
But I don't want to pay a lot of money for
that. You're thinking that Steve Rogers didn't have significant impact in the Endgame.
No, he had a really good impact. I just
you know
want
to
pay for his shield.
But this conversation.
Oh, so you're making justifications of not paying for the shield.
I won't pay for his shield. His name is Chris.
This conversation would be great because we still have to finish. We still have to finish the What If stuff. So we
okay.
Yes,
we do have to do a whole Marvel episode.
Yes, we know you. We want you want to do that.
No, I just want to close it out because the Hawkeye is about to start next month.
Okay.
And we still got Eternals coming out at the end of this next week.
It's too much.
And we still ain't talk about Venom.
I didn't watch Venom.
And it's a lot of Spider-Man stuff going on, if y'all haven't noticed.
Well, you know, Prodigy, you know what? If you could pencil us in into your busy schedule, you could lead all of that. Because I haven't seen Venom, and I'm pretty sure seen it, haven't seen it. So guess what? You can lead that.
Fine, I will lead it.
And Loki is not a killer.
He is a killer.
What?
He kills people.
No.
All right, we're gonna raid DJ Cremo.
Oh, we ending on that note. Okay, thank you so much, everybody, for joining us today. It was pretty cool going through all of the songs for the horror movies. I'm surprised that I knew what I knew for a person that really doesn't watch horror movies, though. But that was actually pretty fun.
But you do. You watch them. Somebody came in the door.
Yeah, that was Savannah checking on me.
Oh, sorry, somebody came in.
You saw the horror thing about to happen.
No, I don't know. I will tell y'all, after I watched Halloween Kills the other night, I slept okay. I wasn't scared. I did sleep under the covers, and I slept in the dark. I didn't have no lights on, but I made it throughout the night.
You didn't sleep with SpongeBob playing in the background like I do after I watched it?
No. No. Like you after you watched E.T.?
It. No. Oh. It.
No.
Because he said it.
He said X.
So we hear your games.
Yeah.
Use your
I do have one horror, non-horror thing to share. It's non-horror.
Hurry up, we're about to raid out.
Okay. So as of today, I have officially seen every single episode of The Big Bang Theory. We know that the movie wait a minute, time out. The Little Mermaid is a horror movie for you? What the what?
She don't have no legs.
We rated out.
Okay. All right, so I'm going to end it.